We are continuing our ArchLinux installation. Let's go. Last time, we've installed the basic system and left it at that. If you haven't done it yet, check out the previous video. This time, I will present you with two options. One will give you a fully working user interface right off the bat. The other is a journey every man has to go through at least once in his life. Install the Gnome meta packet and just go with all the default options. It will give you a complete Linux experience and all of the quality of life features enabled and ready to go. Enable the GDM service so that the graphical interface will start automatically upon the next reboot. And now you have...
boring, wet, white rice motherfucker! What?!
Jokes aside, this setup is perfectly fine if you want system up and running quick and not worry about deeply diving into config internals to get stuff done. If we check our currently used resources, we can see that in this configuration, system is using slightly less than 1 GB of RAM.
Not great, not terrible.
I think we can do a bit better. As usual, all the instructions are in my GitHub repository. Link in the video description and in the pinned comment. Assuming you didn't go for GNOME, install Sway with some extra stuff. This will give you working baseline interface with fallback support for Xorg applications. Create your users.config/sway directory in your home and copy default Sway config file from /etc/sway/config. We still need to install our terminal emulator. I'm going for Alacrity, but you can use whatever you want. Edit the .config/sway/config file and change the set footline so it matches your chosen terminal software. Now we can actually start the graphical environment and do the rest from there. If you're not familiar with Sway or i3, you should look up the key cheat sheet. I'll link some in the video description. For the sake of the video not having stuff magically appear, I'll display the keystroke combos I'm pressing in the bottom right corner. By default, the mod key corresponds to the Windows key, but it can be changed in Sway's config. Mod and enter starts our terminal, and I like mine a bit transparent. So go ahead and create .config alacrity alacrity.aml, and within that file, change your opacity settings. Make sure to use double space as an indent, since this is a YAML file. Go ahead and create directories for your AUR packages, and clone Sway Launcher to there. Fetch the required dependencies and install the package using make-pkg. Now we have to tell Sway to actually use our new launcher. Go to the Sway's config file, comment out the current launcher line, and put these two lines that define not only new launcher, but also the way it is displayed. Using mod shift C, you can reload Sway without closing it. It looks like I've made a typo, and Sway points me to the problematic line. After you fix it, reload again. Install your chosen web browser and test out the launcher. By default, you can call it using mod D. Next, we will configure the status bar. Go to the Waybar GitHub page and navigate to the examples. Choose any example as your baseline and copy both config and style.css to your .config/waybar directory. Again, we have to tell Sway to start using our custom bar software, so navigate to the config file, remove existing bar configuration, and write new launch command. Reload to see your new status bar. To enable Lockscreen, install Sway Lock and Sway Idle packages. You have to uncomment the relevant config lines manually. And if you want to, you can opt for custom image being displayed while the screen is locked, just like I am doing now. The power off-on option does not shut your whole computer, only cuts power to the screen. Because I am used to Windows key plus L locking my computer, I will set the same keystroke to lock my screen on my setup. Unfortunately, it collides with an existing keystroke, so I am going to comment it out since I won't be using it anyway. Press Mod Shift C to reload config and test out your locking screen. Finally, set your desired desktop background, which is really easy. You just need to edit the correct line in your config file and change the path. Since this is a secure setup, choose a background that won't make you stand out. After rebooting, Pulse Audio started running and you can see the current sound level. For the last piece of config in this tutorial, I will show you how to make the sound icon clickable so you can adjust sound using it. Edit the waybar config file, and in my case, it's just a matter of changing the defined behavior. Install Pulse Mixer and enjoy your new tiling setup. Oh, and one last thing. Compared to GNOME, we are using only 230 MB of RAM, which is around 4 times less. Obviously, you will want your own tweaks and changes, but the rest is a part of your own journey. Next time, final notes on basic system hardening. If you enjoyed this part of the tutorial, liking and subscribing would be greatly appreciated.